Good morning on Friday the 29th of September, and I hope that the week so far has gone well for you all. Our opening prayer. Loving Lord, we are aware of our human shortcomings. We ask that by your Holy Spirit you give us strength to work for that which is good, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today's readings are from Daniel chapter 12, verses 1 to 4, and Psalm 34, verses 1 to 9. I think that we really do struggle to get our heads around the idea of angels. Arguably, it's nativity plays which do a disservice to us relating to this. Of course, there's no denying the fact that angels play a huge role in the events prior to Jesus' birth. So, of course, it's important that angels are in the nativity play. However, traditionally, they tend to be played by a girl aged about 7 years old with blonde hair and blue eyes. We all enjoy watching the nativity plays, but the portrayal of angels also hides some of the serious tasks which the angels do as God's special messengers and warriors in the spiritual battle, and guardians of our spiritual well-being. Angels have a status between God and humans through their involvement in serious spiritual warfare. We are helped to taste and see that the Lord is good. In our reading from Daniel today, we hear something about the end times. Archangel Michael is described as the protector of God's people. The passage talks about names being written in the Book of Life. However, there is also mention of those whose names aren't in that book. It is effectively speaking about the Day of Judgment, a message which tends to be rather unfashionable in this day and age. And because of that, people tend to shy away from the message. But it is vitally important that we hear what is said, because it's everything to do with life and death. Yesterday, I spoke about how the St. Luke's premises are a base for God's mission in that area. This is to make sure that in a variety of ways, people are made aware of the life-saving message of Jesus Christ. And of course, this isn't exclusive to St. Luke's. It's the purpose of every church fellowship, wherever it is based in the world. Today is the day that we give thanks for Michael and all the angels. And our next prayer picks up on this. Everlasting God, you have created the ministry of angels and humans in wonderful order. Grant that as your holy angels always serve you in heaven, so that at your command they help and defend us here on earth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We come to our prayer points and let's pray for God's protection on his work here on earth. Pray for children and young people that they Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. No doubt you're starting to make your plans for this coming weekend. Why not include the reopening of St. Luke's for worship at 11 o'clock this Sunday morning in your plans? It will be lovely to see you joining us in worship today. And our blessing, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, teach you to walk his way more trustfully, to accept his truth more faithfully, and to share his life more lovingly, that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may come as one family to the kingdom of the Father. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and